those four are the only ones that we've plugged so far. All because of settlement of that and because of, you know, settlement on the pad three. We just didn't want to have a well drilled. I've already talked about the new south berm. We were putting plans together to actually install a cut through on the old south berm since we got the new one completed, so that we could let the water inside and outside equalize. But I think last week we went over the top and cut through the south. So I think our plan at this point in time, we're probably going to put barricades over here and over here so we don't see the traffic coming in and let Mother Nature do its thing. And that way we don't put any equipment out there.
Where did you cut through that?
Neil, do you remember where exactly it cut through? It was one of the, it was like about where
this,
that
this is the MRA land about the center between there and
yeah,
the,
about
that's where it subsided the first.
Yeah, it's where we saw the settlement.
The lowest point is where it broke.
Yeah.
What we refer to as survey pit number 12.
Well,
that's where we caught the middle of the berm.
So when y'all saying cut through, you mean first y'all said over top, now you're saying cut through, so well, it breached, I mean it
yeah,
broke.
Yeah, it went over the top and it actually cut some.
And it made a pathway
made
of its
a
own
path
through the berm.
We're just going to barricade it and let it do its thing.
Just because, I mean, that's the only thing about that, I mean, I know that the outer berm was just additional protection, but by allowing all that water and stuff to freely go past the old south berm, it's letting everything get closer, you know, letting all that water get closer to the Bayou Corne now, versus trying to keep hold of it back.
We continue to see water only flow in. All we saw our outside berm, since we completed the berm early last year, we've seen water, we've only let water in, we've never discharged any water. So the water flow is from the berms into the center of the thing.
And where are they going?
It's going probably down in the MRA office. There used to be about 100 foot of clay above it now because of the sinkhole it's exposed.
So the overtop and the cut through this time was just because of all the rain, you're saying?
Yeah, yeah.
So we were, this time it did go from sinkhole to out?
No, it went from the intermediate area, it went from this area into this area.
So the space between the two berms, it went back in.
We did not have any culverts in this area. We were working to just get this in our inlet culverts for over here, I think. So we didn't equalize it. We wanted to make sure that we kept that intact, didn't do anything out there. We finished this berm, and we're getting ready. I think our recommendation was to put a cut through about here so that we could equalize it and let normal water go where it's going to go, because we've got the berm completed.
You have a culvert on the outer berm?
Yeah, we have them out here, and I think we've got a couple over here.
You have some kind of check valve to keep it
there? We got a manual valve that we monitor and close off.
Each transfer location has two pipes.
Two pipes.
So we can see the
two here and two there.
So the water's steadily coming from outside the berm and to
when
the
berm. We open the valve, go out there.
Okay.
So at this point in time, that's about all we have planned on the berms. We have plans in hand or submitted to DNR associated with the 10th Amendment to install some passive vent wells at the larger bubble sites. We're waiting on comments back from DNR, so we haven't taken action on that. It's probably 5 or 6 shallow passive vent wells to try to help those bubble sites vent off any quicker.
Bubble sites have slowed down a lot.
We think they have.
Go ahead.
I rode to the pipeline and I couldn't believe the difference from last time I was out there.
We continue to
third of what they were at one time.
Right there in the pipeline crossing, yes. Grand Bayou, 1, 2, and 3, and Trish Canal.
No, they have slowed down. They have slowed down.
With the impression dropped on these CT 138 and 3637. Just the first part, I'm sure you can cover that.
I'm sorry, what
now? On the CBC 130, the one by the highway right here. The pressure drops in the last few months.
We're seeing a little bit of pressure drop on 36, but we're venting pretty hard from it. The CPT showed about a 50% reduction in the thickness of gas from what it did when we first did the CPT.
Even though you don't have any pressure drop, you're still showing a reduction.
We're seeing, you know, when we first put in 36, I want to say the wellhead pressure was probably the neighborhood about 50 when it first started in.
So you had like 12 foot wells?
I don't think it was ever that much. It was less than 10.
So right now you got like 4 foot?
We have about, at 36, this one, originally it was 3.6 feet, and now we're showing about 1.8 feet.
Pressure should correspond to that.
And originally, I think, if my memory serves right, we were around 50 pounds, and we're showing about 45 pounds. They, you know, the numbers add up. We did just get some comments back from DNR on the response that we put in for the Third Amendment air monitoring program, and we're going through those and giving, you know, our responses to their comments. From a property standpoint, we continue to look for ways to reduce our overall costs and look at how to get rid of this command trailer and help the parish move the emergency response people to clean this out. We are looking at the potential of the Sanchez property. But that's, you know, that's somewhere down the road. But just to keep that on the table, because it's, you know, there's fewer people here right now, and we're just trying to figure out how to shrink our footprint as we get closer and closer to the point we want to be. We are looking at a couple of houses north of Highway 70 of having some Tetra Tech workers that are going to be here longer term live in, just to make it easier for them. I don't think they've met.
Is it Mike Taylor?
No, Mike was living in a house up there, but Mike's primarily up in Memphis now. He's pretty much on call, but not coming down for the entertainment. So anyway, our plans for the next 90 days. We're going to continue to vent gas and monitor through the PMWs. I won't be surprised if we do some additional repeat CPTs. We wanted to do this first group to just get some data on that. We think we'll be putting in some passive vent wells, shallow, out in the swamp, out near the bayou, near the largest bubble sites, to see if we can help them vent off faster. It'll also allow us, if we're successful, it'll allow us to monitor pressures and sample that gas, which it's pretty difficult now. Part of that plan is also on some of the bubble sites to actually put a collection cap and allow it and vent it over to the side of the bayou, some of those that are in the bayou, the smaller mobile sites, to actually monitor pressure and flows and be able to take samples. So that's probably the biggest part of the work that's left is that response to the 10th Amendment. I talked about confirming CPTs and then putting plan together for possible P&A activity on relief wells that have depleted.